Are you looking for one of the top public schools in the state of Indiana and the nation? If so, stay tuned, and I'm going to highlight one of the local schools here in Southern Indiana with excellence that it's providing to its students. Hi, I'm Carrie Henshaw from Key Associate Signature Realty, and I love doing videos of work, living, and playing here in Southern Indiana. If you're new to our channel, make sure you tap that subscribe button. Wouldn't want you to miss any of the videos that we do once a week at least. And if you've been watching, well, welcome back. We appreciate your time of watching our channel, and give us a thumbs up for that feedback. It always helps me know what to film and get out in regards to information to my listeners. So today I'm gonna give a highlight on one of the top schools here in downtown Evansville. So today, this is very exciting for me. We are gonna have kind of an interview here on a student, Anna King. So someone that I've watched grown up from little baby to graduating here at Signature School as valedictorian, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
She just graduated 2021. And is headed to Stanford, I hear.
Yep.
Very exciting. And is an engineer?
Yep, chemical engineering.
Chemical engineering. And I'm an industrial engineer, so yeah. I'm a little biased. I'm Purdue. Stanford is great. You know, they used to say Purdue kind of was Ivy League with the name because it wasn't a state. I'm just joking. She does have a Purdue family, so I can up the Purdue a little bit here, considering her dad was a professor there.
Yeah.
So, but no, Stanford is outstanding. Very, very exciting. Congratulations. Yeah. You've done amazing things. One thing that I think is amazing, she's been a star from a little girl. She even was in Costa Rica. And how old were you?
From fifth grade to eighth grade.
And she studied under a second language being taught. That is just amazing. And now valedictorian of Signature, or one of them, and heading to Stanford. So congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, Signature, Anna.
Yes.
It's kind of this unknown. I mean, everybody wonders, what is this school all about?
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit?
Sure, yeah. It's a charter school, but it's also a public school, so it's free, and you don't have to do an application to apply to get in. You have to enter your name into a lottery, and every year they take about 100 to 110 students, and they have a lottery drawing, and then the students who aren't selected first are put on a wait list, and so pretty much everybody who wants to go gets the chance to go.
And
I think.
Is that 100, and you said 130, is that per class? Or what are the grade ages here?
It's only 9 to 12.
9 to 12, and that's about 130 per class.
Mm-hmm. 100 to, it's 100 to 110-ish.
Okay, 110. Okay, but that's each grade.
Uh-huh.
Very cool. And it's free.
Yeah, it's free. Yeah.
I don't think people realize that. It is a free charter school.
So it's still a public school, so
And just to, like, everybody doesn't realize this, it's like the 10th. School in the nation, right?
Yep.
That's just really, really neat that we have that sitting here in Evansville, Indiana, right here. We're downtown for people that don't know where it's located. In regards to doing like the counties, does it matter where you live if you want to go to Signature School? Like, do you have to be in Vandenberg, Warwick, or?
It doesn't matter. I know people who come from Warwick, Posey County, Gibson County. I'm coming from Spencer County, so. It really doesn't matter.
That is so neat. So it's how did it get started? Do you know?
I think it started in 2006 as a half-day school. So people from EVSC would come for special like AP classes and that kind of stuff, and then it turned into a full-day school.
And because it's public and obviously it's a raffle system, you don't have to be like this brilliant, the smartest person to want to come here.
Yeah.
The character I hear a lot about is people come here because it's that learning environment everybody really wants to be a part of, the students as well as the teachers and the parents, right?
Yeah. So going to school here is definitely more challenging than other high schools. I've taken about 13 AP classes, I think, while I've been here. There's a lot of homework and that kind of stuff, but as long as you're responsible and do your homework on time, I think it's definitely manageable. A lot of people worry about that, but it's really not that bad. And then also one of my favorite things is that the school is downtown, so we don't have a cafeteria, but for lunch we can go eat at the downtown restaurants like Milano's and Subway and that kind of stuff. And we also have kind of like a separated campus. We have three buildings that we take classes in. The main building here, we have a new science center, and we also take classes in the Victory Theater. So in between classes, we get to walk outside, and it's kind of almost feels like a college campus type vibe. The students here are super amazing. Everyone is here to learn, so the classes are super focused, and really everybody is super accepting, which is amazing. It's known as an anti-bullying school as well, so everybody is nice to each other. I think I could say that I'm friends with almost everyone in my class, so it's super, the vibe here is just super amazing. So
Anna, there's a lot of things that are very unique about this school, and one thing that I love is the arts.
Yeah.
Tell me about that, because they definitely highlight the arts here. It's It's an important item to the school as well, right?
Yeah. So one of the things that I think is really cool is every freshman here gets to take this class called Fine Arts Connections, and everybody, it's kind of like you get to try out so many different things. You don't just do like the typical painting and that kind of stuff. You also do like musical theater and piano and sculpting and filmmaking, sewing even, and cooking.
Cool.
So it's kind of like very...
I'm gonna be a movie star.
I came here for like more of the science and math, but I was definitely kind of like, this is kind of interesting, you know, kind of different, but...
Well, it's neat because like even from like the valedictorian standpoint, I noticed there was multiple valedictorians, and that allows even the arts, there's no weighted in regards to the way they look at the valedictorians, right? They really are supporting all fields, which is great for a kid's standpoint of not really making it biased with anything, really.
Yeah.
Just the student doing a good job and working hard towards whatever they love.
Yeah.
So very cool. So there's also, you were talking about a diploma about Indiana. I'm going to just let you talk about, because I'm not sure exactly what you're talking about. So
yeah, so pretty much every student here gets the Indiana Academic Honors Diploma, which is just the state's diploma, but they also get the International Baccalaureate Diploma. It's this globally recognized diploma that is common in a lot of international schools around the world. So it's like you have to take so many classes. Those classes do have tests, but they also have interesting projects that you get to do that have kind of like a real world implications.
Her overseas again someday.
For sure.
I was in Australia one time. You become a travel addict a little bit when you leave. So that's very cool. Well, that's really neat that they have that.
Yeah, and you also, one of the requirements is that you have to take a world language for 4 years. So everybody here has to choose either French, German, or Spanish.
Did you do a different language or Spanish?
I did Spanish, and
she went the easy route.
Yeah.
I'm just joking.
I did a little bit of French, so
very cool.
I did both. Yeah.
I'm sure you're even more fluent now.
Yeah,
I mean, you were pretty fluent even when you came
back. And you also have
to
do community service.
You probably helped other people in school, actually, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I tutored for several people, and it was, it was really, everybody really helps each other.
Very
out,
neat.
Yeah.
So any other type of programs that you can think of that may be not in the typical high school in Southern Indiana that you may want to highlight, or?
Yeah, everybody here also has to do community service, so you have to get 25 hours of community service each year, but that can be, you know, you can really find something that is interesting to you.
I did not know that.
And the school does a lot of community service too, like as a class we would go clean up downtown or do that kind of stuff, so that's a big focus of the school too.
It has a lot of, everything's great about it in regards to focusing on not only just the education, but just the well-roundedness of a person living in their community and supporting it. So very cool.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Anna, so much for the highlight here on Signature School. It's always, I think, a wonder to everybody, and I think it's great that you gave and shared your experience on information about the school and what a great job they're doing. And I think a lot of people don't realize how well known they are for being a public school here in Southern Indiana that you have access to.
Yeah.
So I do appreciate it. Thank you. And I wish you the best of luck at college. Don't forget about us. Come back and congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah. Thanks.
I hope you liked my highlight on Signature School here in downtown Evansville. Anna did such a great job, and I really appreciate her doing this interview to make sure we share what special schools we have around us here in Southern Indiana. So if you need any information, feel free to contact me at 812-686-3268. And until next time, I'll see you then.